Maar ik ben deel van de mensen, want is al een schuld.
Is we have all the other different styles of port, which is what we normally call our day-to-day drinking ports, from the ruby ports, the tawny ports, and even the white ports. So that allows us as a business that the rubies and the tawnies are the ports that we have to keep the business flowing. And vintage port is all about selecting the best ports from the best years. Because if you have a business pressure onto what you put in the bottle, then you will sooner or later compromise what goes in there. So that's what makes vintage port very much the most exclusive of all of the categories of port. And today we're very much focusing on vintage, and we're focusing on the differences in the years within vintage port. But before we get into that in more detail, into the tasting, I'd like to go back to the Dole Valley where port is produced. As I said, the Dole Valley is this isolated region of what we call mountain viticulture in the northeast of Portugal. And it is very much mountainous terrain. So our vineyards are planted on these steep terraces. It is mountain viticulture in hot climate, and it is normal for us to get up into the 40 degrees centigrade. These are very extreme conditions. We have very low rainfall, and the soils are very poor, very low organic matter. And it is these conditions that produce such concentrated grapes, which then are best translated into producing port wine. I normally say that port is the best suited wine, is a fortified wine for hot climates. It is also very important that when we think about port, we think about it in the wine world. We're not a spirit, we're not a liqueur. It is port wine. And that what differentiates us with port from a normal red wine is that you could have the same vineyard, same viticulture. If you're making a red wine, you take your grapes, you ferment all the sugar until they're dry, and you'll get a red wine. With port, what we do is we are taking the same grapes, but halfway through the fermentation, we stop the fermentation by adding a neutral grape spirit that kills the yeast. It retains the sugar, the natural sugar from the grapes, so all of the sweetness in port is your natural sugar from your grapes, and we're taking your alcohol up to 20%, which is very important to both for the character and to keep it stable. So port is very much a fortified wine. And these vineyards that we're talking about, the traditional vineyards of the Douro, are all very labor intensive in that all the work is done by hand. And the other feature of the port vineyards is the grape varieties that we use. We use local Portuguese grape varieties which Tarrega Nacional is nowadays better known around the world, but Tinta Roriz, Tinta Barroca. But what is also very interesting is that these grape varieties in the traditional vineyards were planted as a randomly mixed within the one vineyard. So the traditional way of growing our vines was to take 10 to 20 different grape varieties, mix them in randomly in a block, which then when the fermentation came, they were mixed in naturally as a blend. And that is a very important point. What has happened over the last 30 years is in our need to simplify viticulture, there have been two changes. One of them is we have developed new vineyard models to be able to mechanize our vineyards in mountain viticulture. But also, initially, and this is going back into the late 70s, early 80s, there was an initial attempt to narrow down the number of grape varieties that we use and plant them in separate blocks and make them separately and then bring them together. That has been a very interesting cycle in itself, because here we have a very good example of the empirical viticulture mixed the varieties in the vineyard for a reason. And we now understand that when you mix those different grape varieties in the fermentation, you get much more complex ports or wines, because each grape variety is going to contribute with a different characteristic. Some will have more color, some will have more tannin, some will have more flavor, some will have more acidity. And when you get that blend together in the right proportion, you make much more interesting ports. And so that is an example of the sort of work that we've had to do over the last 30 years in our viticulture. As far as winemaking is concerned, and go back to this traditional method of foot treading. Well, why is foot treading such a feature in port? Well, as I was saying earlier, the main difference between making a red wine and making a port is that with a port, we've got to stop the fermentation halfway through. As a result, we have a very short time to extract all of the color and all of the tannin out of the skins. So however primitive the foot treading might sound, it is actually a very effective way of extracting all of your color and all of your tannin from your grapes in a very short period of time without being overly aggressive. Well, when I did my first work experience at home between school and college in the 80s, foot treading used to be the practice for probably 80% of ports that were being made. And what happened since is that it was no longer possible to continue foot treading. And so alternative technology was brought in initially from table wine to replace the foot treading. And what we discovered is that alternative technology did not produce port with the same intensity or quality as the traditional foot treading. And so again, one of my big jobs that I was faced with when I came back home in 1990 was trying to design an alternative to foot treading, because we had no choice. And then we were very creative, and we developed what we call our Porto fermenters. We now have fermentation tanks with these mechanical plungers which simulate the treading. They're not as fun. You can imagine a winery with 40 or 50 people treading. You have music, you have good looking girls. A traditional winery's got character. These modern wineries, they're very efficient, but they haven't got the same character. But the reality is that for me, in the period that I've been working back at home, is this in itself has been a very interesting period to try to invent a fermentation technology which replicates your traditional foot treading. And that has now happened, and that has been very important to guarantee the quality of ports which are not being foot treaded. Having said that though, one thing that we have in common with every single port on this table right up to our most recent 2009 vintage, is that every single port here has been for Trump. Well, the reason for that is that the traditional foot treading of these granite lagars is a very simple and it's a very effective method which has been perfected over the centuries. And one of the beauties of foot treading in lagar is that as a winemaker, you're not putting your personality into the port. And that is a very, very important philosophy when it comes to vintage port and house style, is that as a winemaker, we are here to bring out the character of the grapes that we are working with. So the beauty of the traditional foot treading is that it is a method that's been so well fine-tuned over centuries that it is very effective. It's almost like a recipe. In comparison with the new technology that we have, the new mechanical plungers now produce ports which are very fruity, very attractive. However, what is important here to understand is over the last 20 years that we've been working with this, is that we could not afford as a port house to play around with vintage port, which is what we are known for. So all of the development was done with all the different styles of port. So during this period, we have made sure that vintage port respects its traditional practices, and any developments being done with the rubies, the late bottle vintage, and even the base wines for the tournament. The conclusion that I have come to today after these 20 years now of working with lagars, with working with stainless steel tanks, is that in effect, vintage port, port produced in a granite lagar by foot treading, has got a different taste profile, a different tannin profile to what is done in stainless steel. So we intentionally continue foot treading for vintage port, and with other styles of port, we happily use our modern technology. And so for me as a winemaker, I'm using very much the best of both worlds here, and then using it according to the different styles that we are producing. So just before we do get into the tasting, and I'll try not to get carried away, I hope you're not all lost by now. There is a lot behind port, but I think understanding the traditional practices in this old world region is very important.
Different levels, and